Hello guys, this is Vivek here, and recently I was in this event named Second IEEE International Conference on Power Electronics, Intelligent Control and Energy Systems, ICPEICES, which was being hosted by the Delhi Technological University in New Delhi. And I was there to present my paper, which is Protection of Power Electronics Switches in a Voltage Source Inverter Against Overcurrent and Shoot-Through Faults. Okay. So I was there to present this paper, and this was also my final year project. So today in this video I am going to describe you about this paper, how all these things are there and what this paper is all about. Okay, so let's first understand inverters. Okay, there are two types, single phase and three phase inverter. An inverter, you know, is a device used to convert DC current to AC. Okay. So its basic work is to convert this DC voltage to AC voltage, and these are of two types, single phase and three phase. And based on what kind of output you need or what you need, there are two types of inverter, voltage source and current source. And these are the PWM technique. This is how you know that inverters have power electronic switches like IGBT or GTO or anything, so they need to be switched at different frequency. So it can be switched using square wave technique or using PWM technique. Under PWM we have these four types, and PWM is most preferred technique of switching. Okay, now this is how a voltage source inverter looks like. Three sections basically are there. This is the DC battery, or it can be a rectification section or rectifier. Okay, it can be replaced with a rectifier. Here we are using batteries. Then this is filtering section. You know that we take three phase AC line and connect it to three phase, or we have single phase rectifier. So after rectification, what we have a pulsating DC. So this filter capacitor is used to convert this pulsating DC to lenient DC. And finally, these are the six IGBTs. We are using IGBT, so I will be talking about IGBT here. So six IGBT, they switch at different instant of time, and from here what we get, three phase AC output, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so this is the three phase output that we get, and we use it in driving purpose or for different purposes it is used. Okay, it is for a voltage source inverter. Now what kind of faults we are talking about today in this video? We are going to talk about overcurrent fault and the shoot through fault. Okay, so overcurrent, you can understand that when the inverter power electronic devices carrying current more than the rated. Okay, so let's say we have a three phase fault at the output. It can be phase to phase fault, phase to earth fault, any kind of fault, or a short circuit. So what will happen? It will try to drag more current from the inverter. Okay, we have protection for our devices that are connected to the inverter. Let's say we have a induction motor connected to the inverter. So there are relays to protect the induction motor, but we don't have such protection inherent for our inverter. So what will happen? The IGBT that I showed in the previous slide, what will happen? This IGBT will carry more current, and eventually it will burn out because of the thermal runaway. Okay, so it is important to protect these IGBTs against overcurrent. So shoot through happens when you can see that there are two IGBT connected in the same limb. Okay, so when these two IGBT begins conduction at the same instant of time, or let's say when the upper one is conducting and the lower one begins to conduct in the same cycle, what will happen? It will just short circuit this DC bus. Okay, this is called the DC bus, this one. So the DC bus will be short circuited, and it will blow up the capacitor, as well as these IGBTs will also blow away. So it is important to protect against any such fault. Why this can happen? This can happen because let's say we have a bad microcontroller program to drive these IGBTs, or it can be because of the electromagnetic interference, because these things are operating at a very high frequency. So there are situations when this high frequency can cause the IGBTs to blow away or to turn on simultaneously because they are not discharged at the current instant of time. So this is the these are the reasons for shoot through. So here we are going to talk about how we can protect against the inverter against overcurrent and shoot through fault. Okay, now let's see the overcurrent protection scheme. This is what you are seeing on the screen, is the overcurrent protection. This is the IGBT we are trying to protect against overcurrent. How we will be doing this? Let us see. So let's say under there is a situation of a fault where this IGBT is made to carry more current than the rated one. Now there is a behavior of an IGBT. What is that? The behavior is that when let's say an IGBT is a positive temperature coefficient type semiconductor, which means with the rise in temperature, the junction resistance also increases, okay, of the IGBT. So under a fault situation, let's say the IGBT is made to carry more current than the rated one, what will happen? The resistance of this junction resistance is also going to increase, and eventually what we will see that the voltage drop across this IGBT will also increase, okay, because the current is rising and the junction resistance is also high. So the voltage drop during overcurrent situation also rises. So we are using this only to protect the IGBT. What we are doing here, let's say the voltage across the collector emitter junction is increasing. So with the help of this diode, this is the feedback diode, with the help of this diode we are taking this voltage drop across collector and emitter, and you can see this is fed back to a op amp or a comparator, okay, with the help of this diode. So it is fed back to this comparator. Now in the comparator it compares it against a level, against a reference voltage that has been provided. This is the normal voltage drop that should be there when the IGBT is normally operating. So this feedback voltage is compared against a reference voltage. Finally, when the fault voltage, as you know that this is under the faulty situation, so the voltage drop will also increase, the plus terminal voltage will also increase, and eventually you can understand that the comparator will send a high output. Now this high output is given to this transistor, to the gate terminal of this transistor. Okay, so this transistor also goes into conduction state. Now when this transistor goes into the conduction state, you can understand this is the plus 15 volt supply for the gate, it is the gate supply, so it will take all the gate current that was going into the gate terminal. Now it will find a short impedance path through this, because there is a negative potential over here and plus 15 volt is there, so there is a total 24 volt line. This one behaves as a 24 volt line, and all the gate supply that was going to the gate terminal now begins to flow through this path. Okay, eventually the gate voltage that is there begins to drop, okay, begins to lower down. So in this way the conduction of the IGBT is stopped. But this is not going to stop the IGBT from conducting. Why? Because we know that the IGBT has a gate capacitance. Okay, and the capacitance of this IGBT gate terminal will hold some charge. So it is also important that we discharge this gate capacitance such that no stray charge that is there at the gate terminal could turn on this IGBT again. So what we are doing here, for that we are using the totem pole configuration of transistor. This is the totem pole configuration. What we do here is that an NPN and this is a PNP type transistor connected in this fashion. The gate terminal of both the IGBT is both the transistor is connected together, and from here the gate terminal of the IGBT is connected. Now see what happens with the help of this. As you know that during fault situation this comparator is sending high output, so this transistor is in conducting state. Okay, this transistor is in conducting state. There is a negative potential over there. Now as this transistor is conducting, you can understand that this behaves like a short circuit path. So the negative potential rises up here, right? Minus 9 volt, because there is a resistance over there, so plus 15 remains up to here, but this line remains at negative potential. Now this negative potential is therefore applied at the gate terminal of the NPN and PNP type transistor. The NPN type transistor goes into cutoff state because at negative potential it doesn't turn on, while the PNP type transistor, as it is getting a negative pulse at the gate terminal, this transistor goes into conduction state. Okay, the PNP type transistor goes into conduction state. Eventually it takes all the charge from the gate capacitance and finally sends it back to this path, to the negative potential, and through this. Okay, so in this way the complete discharge of the gate capacitance is done, and in this way the total the IGBT is completely stopped, or you can say it is completely made to go into cutoff state when there is a overcurrent situation. Now you can understand that when the situations will be in normal again, will be in normal condition, let's say the overcurrent fault is clear now. So what will happen, this voltage drop across this junction will decrease, this will be sensed by this comparator, and as the reference voltage is there, so if the voltage drop across the IGBT is going to decrease, the comparator will now send a low output. Okay, as this is sending a low output, this transistor will go into cutoff state. This negative potential will not be will not be there anymore. Okay, there will be positive pulse only appearing over here because of the plus 15 volt, and this plus 15 volt will now be being applied at this terminal. Okay, as this is a positive pulse, the NPN transistor will go into conduction state while PNP will be in cutoff state. When this NPN transistor is conducting, it will take all the plus 15 volt from there and directly apply it to the gate terminal of the IGBT. So upon receiving the positive pulse, this IGBT will again go into conduction state. So this is what we were trying to do, that basically what it is doing, it is a self understanding process, that when there is an overcurrent situation, this scheme that is we are using here, it will turn off the IGBT, and when the overcurrent situation is completely stopped, or let's say the fault is clear, it will again make the IGBT go into conduction state, and all the processes that were working will now work as a normal situation. Okay, now so what we are using here, we are using VLF54201R gate driver IC. You can see the name, it is given, hybrid gate driver IC. It is used to drive the gate terminal of the IGBT, as well as it is also used for protection against overcurrent. This overcurrent scheme that I shown you here, it is completely made inside this gate driver IC. So this is a hybrid gate driver IC used for proper gate driving as well as overcurrent fault protection. Now let us talk about the shoot through. As I mentioned, what happens during a shoot through, two of the IGBT connected in the same limb, this is the one of the limb, two of the IGBT will turn on simultaneously. Okay, or let's say when the upper one is conducting, suddenly from nowhere the lower one also begins conduction. So what will happen, this line will be completely short circuited, and it will also affect all the circuit that is connected across here, as well as this IGBT will carry short circuit current and will blow away. So it is important to protect against shoot through. For that, what we are using, we are using optocouplers. Okay, this is what is an optocoupler. In a normal transistor, you know that when we have a gate terminal, when a positive pulse is applied, this transistor begins the conduction. But in an optocoupler, what we have, instead of a gate terminal, we have an LED. Okay, like this. This is an LED. When the LED turns on, this transistor goes into conduction state. When the LED turns off, this transistor goes into cutoff state. So that's what is here. This is the LED. Okay, and this is the our transistor that is there. So this is called an optocoupler or optotransistor. It is also known as like that. Now, we are using here the optocouplers. How they are helpful, let's see. Let's say that the upper transistor is going to conduct and the lower one should be in cutoff state. Now when the upper IGBT is conducting, you can understand the gate supply has been given, the plus 15 volt is appearing from the gate supply. So the plus 15 volt is appearing. Now this plus 15 also turns on this LED. Okay, now what this LED will do, when this LED will turn on, this transistor will be in conducting state, and you can see this is the A1 terminal. So the A1 is connected over here, A1, and this is A2 terminal, this is connected over here in the lower IGBT. So basically what happens, let's say the upper LED, upper IGBT is conducting, the LED turns on, this transistor goes into conduction state, eventually it short circuits this terminal and this terminal, that is the gate terminal of the totem pole transistor over here and the minus potential, so that this always remains at the negative potential. Okay, you can understand now that what it is doing, this transistor will be in short circuited state as this LED is on, so it will short circuit this one. Okay, So that this negative potential, this is minus 9 volt, this will always be appearing at the totem pole transistor, and eventually this NPN transistor will be in cutoff state while this will be in conduction state. So always the gate terminal, always this gate terminal of the IGBT will be in discharge mode, so that if any stray pulse tries to appear at the gate terminal of the IGBT, it will be just discharged because this PNP type transistor is in on state and it is independent of the this state of this transistor. Okay, so during shoot so in this way completely the fault that can happen because of shoot through is completely avoided. Okay, so when you can say that when the upper IGBT is conducting, there is no chance that the lower IGBT will conduct. Now when the cycle is completed, when the upper IGBT cycle is completed, this lower IGBT is made to conduct. So again the same thing happens, this LED turns on, this transistor goes in conduction state and short circuits this one. Okay, so as this is short circuited, the negative pulse is appearing, the PNP type, NPN type transistor goes in cutoff state, the PNP goes in conduction state, and it will just discharge this gate terminal to the minus potential. Okay, so this remains always at negative potential, and if any stray pulse tries to appear, it will be neutralized. Okay, so this is the shoot through protection scheme. Now this is the combined overcurrent and shoot through protection scheme. You can see this is a VLA54201R hybrid gate driver IC. Pin 5 is from where we get the IGBT gate pulse. Okay, this is the totem pole configuration, this is the optocoupler configuration for shoot through protection, and these are the two IGBT. This has been shown, there are total 6 IGBT, 3 limbs, 2 connected in each limb, and this is one of the sections. There are total 3 such sections in a VSI. This is the logic pulse, this is a 3 phase logic pulse from the microcontroller. You know that we are using microcontroller DSP30F2010. Okay, this is being used, DSP30F2010 microcontroller used for proper gate driving. So this is the 3 phase gate driver pulse from the microcontroller. This is the gate pulse that is appearing for the upper and lower IGBT. You can see that when the logic is that the upper and lower ones should not be at same should not be turned on simultaneously. So you can see when this one is lower, this one is at high state. Okay, so no two IGBT in the same limb will be in same state simultaneously. When one is off, the other one is on. Okay, and when this is off, this is on. Okay, so this is the logic pulse. This is the gate pulse during normal operation for the upper and lower IGBT, and this is during shoot through. What we tried to do, we tried to write a bad microcontroller program where we made to run two of the IGBT connected in the same limb, one at 1 kilohertz, another at 10 kilohertz. And you can see when the lower one is conducting, we try to turn on the upper one. It tries to turn on, but it will just be quenched back because of the shoot through protection that has been applied. You can see both of the IGBT try to turn on simultaneously. The lower one is working fine as it should do. The upper one tries to turn on, but it will be quenched back because of the shoot through protection scheme. This is the dead time implementation. You know that the upper and lower IGBT need some dead time to be implemented because they do not turn on and turn off as we talk ideally. So there is a 5 microsecond delay that has been provided. You can see this takes 5 microsecond to turn off, and that is the time that has been given for switching on of the other IGBT in the same limb. So there is a dead time implementation of the IGBTs turning on and turning off. Okay, this is of 5 microsecond. You can see here. So again here it is written. Okay, 5 microsecond. So these are some of the pictures of our actual project. You can see we tested with this tungsten lamps. Okay, this is our this is our inverter, and this is the control board for the gate driver IC, and these are some transformers for plus 15 and minus 9 volt supply. Okay, this is the CRO or oscilloscope that we are using for graphical graphs and all pictures. This is one of the views, and this was clicked when we were making the board for the first time. Okay, for the six IGBTs, these are the optocouplers that I was talking about. This has been shown here, and this is one of the pictures we taken when we were testing the the inverter using this tungsten lamps. Okay, so this video, thanks for watching, and do share your feedback. If you have any query, if you have any question, please send it to in the comment box below, and do not forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.